still have the Rockies, and I'll be interested to see who he's got. He kind of hinted around that he might go with a rivalry team, so I'm looking for maybe Dodgers. I'm thinking Diamondbacks, possibly. So we know who we got. And I go the wrong way every time. I go down instead of up. Up makes you go towards the NL West, and down makes you go towards the AL East. So he is going to go with the Cincinnati Reds. Very interesting. We're going to go with the alternate. We're going with the purple jerseys. He's going old school throwback with the road 34 jerseys. We're going to play during the middle of the day, July. Now, we cannot take John Gray, but we can take Tyler Anderson or Kyle Freeland. I want to go with a lefty right here. I'm pretty sure lefties are going to be better than righties. I think I want maybe Tyler Anderson. Cutter, he has a changeup cutter. Freeland at least has a slider. Yeah, we're going to go with Kyle Freeland right here. Go with that slider. Now, I'm liking the lineup. Just leaving it as is. So we'll be taking on Luis Castillo. I wonder how accurate he's going to be. May have a little trouble pitch location with him. So we're going to try to work the counts a little bit, I think. And, of course, the bullpen. Raisel Iglesias. We do know that is a good arm in the pen. So this Cincinnati team may be a sneaky team. Interesting choice by Big Tater. Oh, Blue's squeezing us a little. All right. Guess get me over fastball. Knew he was taking all the way right there. Just wonder with Billy Hamilton. Oh, we walked him. Oh, no. Let's go, LeMahieu. Bare hand. What a play. Why can't we get that in ranked seasons? You know, ranked seasons, he would have possibly just missed that ball. Or not even tried. There we go. Oh my gosh. How was that a ball? That is going to be rough for us. If we're not going to get that call, it could be really rough. And he went after the slider right there. Maybe bailed us out a little. Every bit of that baseball was in the strike, so that might have been the reason he swung at it, just because he felt bad against that call, maybe, hopefully. Arenado picks it clean, takes his time, throws him out at first, so... Three up, three down. Luckily, effectively wild maybe was Kyle Freeland. Feel for pitches swinging at him versus just taking. And then kind of take later in the game. I know that's not the best strategy always, but sometimes that works best for me. I guess that was a little change up. Yeah, that change up. We got just on top of. Oh, he left the change up floating over the middle. And Charlie Blackman did not miss it. And it is 1-0. And Castillo may be hanging that change up a little. Is he going to come back with fastball now? Maybe. Oh, we guessed right. Is it going to get down? Billy Hamilton's too fast. There's out number two. And there's where I swung at a bad pitch because I guessed right. You know, I was looking for the fastball. I got it and I swung at it. Well, the umpire cannot give him that call and not give me a complete ball in the strike zone. They do know we are the home team, don't they? All right, 0-2. Is he going to come back with one more fastball? He went changeup. I read it just a hair late. Oh, and he gets a throw error. He got the throwing error, and that went down as a base hit. Wow. Oh, did I get under the slider or did I stay on it well? No, we stayed on it. I felt like the slider was coming back, and Trevor Story makes it 3-0. He takes a little changeup, got in on him a little bit. Perar will make the play, so the error for Nola does not come back to haunt us, and it's still 3-0. Wait on a pitch to hit. Maybe I should try to hit with every batter like a pitcher. I mean, 3-2 count. The most pitches we've seen with any batter has been the pitcher. Oh, and look at there. Freeland is going to take the changeup the other way for a double. So he worked 6 pitches and he gets a double. At bat of the game so far. Oh, and DJ was right on that slider. And I might have dropped under it a touch. Maybe a touch. I was trying to take it to right center, and I guess I was just a touch behind it. Jose Peraza. He got just under that slider. I don't know if he's having trouble picking up the slider, or it's not breaking as much as it should, or if he's just getting one of those games where he's hitting it well and it's just not going anywhere. Let's go DJ. LeMahieu's going to bring it in. So 2 quick outs right here. But do have to play smart, have to play well. Oh my gosh, Billy Hamilton is going to take Kyle Freeland yard. I did not think Billy could do that. To tell you the truth, I just did not think Billy Hamilton had that in him. Oh, and Scooter is going to chop one down the line. If he goes, oh. I was going to say, Gerardo Parra has an extremely good, accurate arm. And if he could have just brought it in, that would have been an out, but he was holding anyway. There you go, Perara. He brings in the one that matters, I guess. But it is 3-1 on the solo home run by Billy Hamilton. Maybe change up down and away. Change up down and in. I felt like he was going change up 3-1. That may be a compliment, I guess, I'm going to give to Big Taylor, because a lot of good players like to go with that changeup 3-1. If you can learn to hit the changeup in hitters' counts, you'll find you have success, because they don't want to go the fastball. Fastball up right here, I think. Slider down. I just feel like he's going to challenge fastball up. He knows how bad I want to hit with cargo. He's not. If he gives me a fastball, it's on this pitch. Maybe not. All right, 1-2. Let's go, Cargo. Oh, we sat back on it. Billy Hamilton's speed. He's not going to get there. We're going to hold Cargo at second, but Nolan will score, so we get that run back. Big double. I think he left the changeup over the middle. No, we just went down and got it. I'm starting to pick up that slider a little bit now and able to check swing on it. Oh, I dropped under it. I felt it. Dang it. I just moved it a little to the right. Good take from Trevor. Oh, that slider looked just like a changeup. I still would have been out front. That was a good slider right there. Where's that slider being? Kind of disappointed he missed his spot. I was looking for that fastball in. Oh, wow. Get foul. Okay, it did get foul. It's on that slider well. I didn't feel like I was that late. Trevor's doing a good job. Good PCI placement and good fight this at bat. Oh, and I knew it was a ball and I couldn't stop swinging. I even quit moving my PCI because I knew it was a good pitch call right there. Oh, we smoked the slider just right at Votto. So we do get one back. 4-5-2 for us on the box score. This has been an eventful first three innings. I'm going to give him some props for going with Cincinnati. I see the appeal of them, but I was worried about their pitching. And he hasn't hit bad with them. You see where I put that pitch? That's a pitch that's a lot of times going to get you with good opponents. A lot of times. Wow. And Freeland has 68 pitches, and his stamina is just not doing well at all. And he is going to steal second. And a little pressure on right here from Big Tater. And he takes it up the middle with Billy Hamilton. Billy Hamilton has been the entire offense for Big Tater, and he's hit well. And I'm going to try to get one more with Freeland right here. He is getting tired. And we're tensing up just a touch. Runner, runner, runner. And Billy Hamilton manages to steal the base after being picked off. Hey, game mechanics. None of us are immune to them. I'll just chalk it down as Desmond the ball slipped out of his hand or something. Oh my gosh, come on, Blue. And I just cannot pitch to Eugenio right here with a lefty. I've got to bring in a righty. Ottavino. He was on the fastball. Is Blackman going to run it down? Yes, he will. So we get out of the inning. Only giving up one run. I feel like that's big for us. And I don't know. I'm probably going to bring in a... he's got good lefty-righty matchups there. I'm wondering... wonder if Ottavino... if he's more valuable than, say, bringing in... We do have David Dahl, Walters. I mean, not a whole lot on the bench. Ottavino. We will bring in David Dahl. Ottavino got that one out. Dahl can get something going for us here. Oh, my gosh. That was a pitch right down the middle, and I was going to kind of try to see a pitch or two. So much for that. I was not ready to hit that. Oh, it says good swing time and all that, but I didn't feel like I was on it. Wow. Now, I feel like I was on that one. All right, Charlie. This dude has a little bit of a funky delivery. Not smart. I'm kind of losing my focus, not having smart at bats. That was a good pitch, and that's a tough delivery to pick up versus Votto. Yeah, we're going to put Mike Dunn in the game. We will have him. That's a good pitch. Oh, that's a good piece of hitting. Man, what a hit with Joey Votto. Sinker running in on the hands. Just took it up the middle for a nice single. Nolan with a little Ole defense at third. see if he's ready for this pitch. Just haven't shown him one of the – oh, and he chased out of the zone. Eyes lit up, chased out of the zone. Ferrar will bring it in, and there he shows off that good arm. Oh, Schebler with that 73 speed, and Trevor Story was really in no hurry to get him out anywhere, anyway. And I got the yellow throw thing, and I should have just, I should have thrown it anyway. I should have just let him throw it. If we make an error, we make an error. That way, it would have been three errors. It would have been an unearned run, technically. We wouldn't have given up an unearned run. And a lot of times on those yellow throws from the pitcher, you will get the out anyway. Oh, he got under the cutter. We missed our spot. He got under it. So we give up that one run. And it is 4-3. And we've just got to hold our breaths. And we got to go with Wade Davis right here. We are empty in the pen. We want this win in a bad way. Oh, great pitch. Oh, my gosh. We have just give up the tying home run on a sinker in on the hands. He was sitting on it, and it is now 4-4. Man, that pitch hung up. And why did I throw that cutter right there? I should have let him try to roll over the... I mean, the sinker. I should have seen if he'd roll over the cutter. And I just wasn't. And he rolled over the cutter with Duvall, but it managed to find a hole. And Wade Davis may need a little talking to right here. We'll give a little mound visit. And after the mound visit, he has no throw meter. Why would he have no throw meter after a mound visit? That's just not cool. And even with having good throws, he can't find a play. We got to go to Chris Russell right here. I mean, I couldn't make another mound visit. He didn't get his meter back after that one. And I told y'all, did I not? Wow. So we do give up the lead. And I told y'all that the lead was not safe. And we had the game where we had the matchup we wanted, and it hung the sinker, left it out over the plate. I didn't feel like I made that bad of a pitch, but it is what it is. There we go. Parara is going to take it up the middle for a single. There we go. We got the tying run on. It's going to go sinker hard in. He did. Wow, I felt like I was on that one. I think I was a touch down and over. All right, so we do have Ionetta up. Ooh, ooh, ooh. All right, Ionetta, let's go, big guy. I may not see much right here. And I got another one. I got my pitch and I missed it. I was just under that pitch. That was the one to walk it off. And I guess we are down to Tony Walters. Can he keep it alive? Oh, I'm sick about that fastball. I knew it was... Oh, I had a feeling he was going to go fastball right there, and I just dropped underneath it. That's a good pitch. And the tying run will make it into second. Tony Walters, he did not get enough of it. And it will be a long, loud out number three. I thought off the bat that ball might have had a shot. What about the performance by Billy Hamilton showing off the power? That was unexpected. Definitely was the player of the game. And I told y'all early on that those missed opportunities were going to come back to haunt me. I gave myself a chance. Wade Davis had a rough out, and I'm just sad that this is the end of the Rockies. There was a few on both sides. I think the cheese evened itself out, which I find it does a lot in a Hall of Fame. The Suarez, of all times for Wade Davis to miss with a sinker. I'll have to watch it back on the video. I didn't feel like I missed my spot. I know I didn't miss my pitch release, but maybe I did miss my location a little. Anyway, it hung up, and that's where Big Tater holds his PCI. So that I know for a fact he was dead center on that one and absolutely crushed it. But anyway, I still enjoyed this even more than any ranked seasons game I played because it was competitive, it was fair, it was legitimate. Hall of Fame difficulty is the where it's at right now. If you want a good, fun, competitive game, get with your buddies. Y'all match up with Major League. Use your Diamond Dynasty teams. Play with your buddies. If you're wondering how to have fun with those cards that you've run, because right now, you may be having fun in ranked seasons. I really haven't. Like I say, I lost this game 5-4, got out, hit 12-8. My team made two errors. I blew a save, a game I should have won. But it felt like baseball, and it was a lot of fun. I appreciate Big Tater for playing these games with me and help, you know, us both trying to help our channel grow. So help me show my appreciation by y'all going, hitting that subscribe button on his channel, showing him support. His quality's getting really good. His sound, everything, he's coming a long way. His thumbnails are getting, he's committed to having a good channel, and y'all just show him a little support, drop him a like, a little comment, and that makes us small channel guys. It makes our day when we get comments from people we don't normally get comments from. We get new subscriptions, things of that nature. So y'all do that for me. And as always, I hope y'all enjoyed it, and I will see y'all later.